Welcome everyone. So today we are going to learn something about composite transformation. In our previous session, we have seen three basic types of transformations, that is translation, rotation, and scaling. So today we are going to learn an important topic, that's composite transformation. So first we come to what is composite transformation. So for that, I would be drawing a basic 2D coordinate system here with X and Y. Okay, so this is the object that I have drawn here with its initial position here. So I would name this as the initial position of the object, right? So when I am trying to perform some basic type of animation on this, so I want this stick man to move 5 steps ahead and then slip down. So I want two tasks to be achieved here. One is I want it to move by 5 steps ahead, and number two is, and then I want it to slip down. Okay, so two tasks to be performed. So if I could see the output of my first step, my output would be, if I am saying that this is X and Y and this is the original position of the object. So my final position of the object moving 5 steps ahead would be somewhere out here, right? So when I want to make this 5 steps ahead, that means I am using the transformation, that is translation. Okay, this is my first step. And my second step says that I need to make it something like, it should look like it's slipping down. Okay, so when I come to my second step, what am I trying to do is, we will quickly have a depiction of it. So this is X and this is Y. So I would be drawing the initial position. Again, next is 5 steps ahead. So I am somewhere out here right now in my second step. And proceeding with this, what I want the object to do now, my program to do now is, it should slide. This object should slide. So that means my object should be something like this. Okay, so this is my step number two, wherein I want it to slip down. And when I want it to slip down, it is also that it lies on the horizontal axis. Okay, so this is my second step wherein my transformation involved would be rotation. Okay, so two transformations involved. One is translation, one is rotation. Please have a look at the order in which the transformations are getting placed. So first is moving. So I say my first is translation. And in the second step, when I want to make it a slip down effect, then I'll be using rotation. So that's my second output. Okay, so when I am taking more than one transformations into consideration, that is what we mean by composite transformation. And when I want more than one transformations to be happening here, so that's when I come to composite transformation. Okay, so now let us quickly have a look at what will be the transformations like. So now, when I take, so I say that my first transformation is translation by some tx ty. So my t is tx ty. And my second step is rotation, right, by some angle theta. Okay, so this is what I know as of now. And when I know this, what we have learned till now is my object is denoted by P. Okay, so now please have a look very carefully. So when I am saying that my first transformation is translation on object P, so what is it? It is T multiplied by P that will give me P dash. So this is my first transformation that I have applied, right? Now what happens next? In the next step, I need to apply rotation. But rotation to be applied on what? Not on P, but on P dash. Because this is the output after translation. Okay, so what I take here is I take P dash here and I multiply it with R to get my P double dash. So this becomes my second transformation. Okay, so my final output is nothing but P double dash. So P double dash is the final position or is the output that I have achieved, taking P as the object, as the initial object position. Okay, so this is when I take translation and when I take rotation into consideration. So more than one transformations involved, that's why I call it as composite transformation. But now, what is the sequence that we have followed? Translation first, I get the output, then on the output I multiply my rotation matrix and I get my final output. Okay, we can also denote this as, have a look very clearly out here. Now I am going to write my M matrix. Now this matrix is called as composite transformation matrix. This is composite transformation matrix denoted by M. Now M is equal to the first transformation is translation, which I am writing on the right side, multiplied by the recent transformation is R. So I have written it in an order of right to left. Okay, from right hand side to left hand side. So my first transformation comes on the right side, my second transformation comes on the left side, because this is the most recent transformation, that is rotation, and this is nothing but your composite transformation matrix. Okay, so this is supposed to be the final outcome for composite transformation matrix. And now what you do, once you get the M matrix, the process is very simple. Now you get the transformation matrix with you, that's the composite transformation matrix. Your next step is to multiply this matrix, that is the composite transformation matrix, multiplied by your point matrix, will give you the final matrix. That's it. Okay, so first step, I try to find out the composite transformation matrix. Second step, I try to find out the final coordinates given the initial position of the object. Okay, so when I say composite transformation matrix, it will be the multiplication of all the matrices of all the transformations that you are going to perform on your object. Okay, so all the transformations will give me the composite transformation matrix, and finally I multiply it with the point matrix to give me the final matrix, right? So this is how I perform a composite transformation matrix.